the logarithm of the inverse ratio of the H plus ion. That means as the H plus ion concentration increases, the pH will decrease. That means it will be more acidic. And if the H plus ion concentration decreases, that means pH will be more increased, going towards the alkalosis. So each unit change in the pH will lead to 10-fold change in the H plus ion. Normally, the pH of the arterial blood is around 7.4, while that of the venous blood is 7.35. That means the venous blood is slightly more acidic than that of the arterial blood. And this is because of the presence of the venous component, because veins take up the excretory aspect. So if there are acidic components to be excreted by the cell, it will be flushed out by the, it will be taken out by the venous blood. That is why it is a slightly acidotic. If the pH of the arterial blood is below 7.4, it is termed as acidosis. While if it is more than 7.4, it is termed as alkalosis. Now there is a range where our body has the ability to control or normalize our pH. Yeah, if it is below 6.5 or it is above 8, death is sure there. The person, the possibility of death in those individuals is sure. We know that there is a pH scale, and it depends upon the H plus concentration in the extracellular fluid, ranging from 10^-8 value. pH 4 is more acidic than pH 6. That you know very well. We will not go into the details. Now, how there is an effect of pH which affects the normal cell function. Firstly, there will be change in excitability of the nerve muscle cell due to the change in the pH that has already been dealt when nerve muscle physiology was taught. The influence on the enzymatic activity is also directly or indirectly affected by the change in the pH. That biochemistry people have well explained. There is an influence on the potassium ion level as well, which actually has a control effect on the regulatory functioning effect of the pH. That also has been talked in the biochemistry, I presume that. Now, if I talk about the change in the excitability, just an overview, that pH decrease, that is more acidic pH, if the environment is having it, there will be depresses the central nervous system. So it can lead to loss of consciousness, that conscious sensation will be lost. But if the pH is at a higher level, going towards the basic or alkaline side, that is alkalosis, it will have an overexcitability. That means the person will have a tingling sensation, nervousness, muscle twitch. So these all things might be because of the change in the pH, whether it is going towards the loss of consciousness or it is because of the higher sensory effect because of the change in the pH. So that is how the pH will affect the cell excitability. Other than that, the most general effect of the pH change are on the enzyme function, right? Whenever the pH is decreased, the excitability is going to decrease. When the pH is increasing, the excitability is going to automatically increase, whether it is a nerve or a muscle aspect, when we talk about the excitability. Now, if I talk about the enzymatic action, the pH increase or the decrease can alter the shape of the enzyme, rendering it, it can be become a non-functional type of an enzyme, which will not cause the reaction to happen. Because whenever there is a change in the enzymatic molecule, it, the substance will not fit. You can see here diagram. This is an enzyme which will cause an enzymatic reaction because of the change in the pH. It will result in the modification of the substrate of the enzymatic component will be modified, and it will not allow the substrate to fit in. So that in turn can cause an effect on the metabolic action within the cell. Now, when we talk about the potassium and the hydrogen ion, there is a compensatory response. When we talked about secretion of H plus ion, secretion of potassium ion, you remember we talked about an potassium hydrogen pump, you remember? So that pump, what is doing it? It's secreting the H plus ion, it is taking up the potassium. Once the potassium, more potassium is inside the blood, it will increase the level of the potassium within the blood, termed it hyperkalemia. But if there is an alkalosis, that means the H plus ion will be move, will not be secreted out at the kidney tubular end, and K plus ion will be entering into the cell. So there will be a compensatory response so as to correct the alkalosis. Okay, but subsequently there will be hypokalemia. That means the pH, entry or exit of the H plus ion, depending upon the pH of the fluid, will in turn, specifically in the blood, it will affect the potassium concentration within the blood. If it is an acidic one, the H plus ion, H plus ion will go out. Subsequently, the potassium will be taken up, and it will cause hyperkalemia, and the vice versa will happen whenever there is alkalosis. Now, different. What are the different sources of H plus ion in the body? Some of the sources which you might have read, carbonic anhydrase. We have been talking about it in RBC. We have been talking about it in cells of the distal convoluted tubule, even the P cells of the collecting tubules. In presence of carbonic anhydrase, where carbon dioxide binds with the water to form H2CO3, which further breaks into H plus ion and bicarbonate. Now, there are certain inorganic, non-volatile type of the acids which are produced during the breakdown of the nutrients. There are also organic type of acids which are because of the intermediate metabolic products, okay, like fatty acids, lactic acid, specifically lactic acid during the exercise. More acid is produced than the base within the body. We don't find much of the base components getting produced within the body. Rather, we have more of the acidic component getting produced. So definitely we need to decrease the pH, decrease the H plus ion concentration because more acids are available. Now, what all acids are available? Physiologically, the most important acids are carbonic anhydrase, phosphoric acid, pyruvic acid, and lactic acid. Okay. We need not go into the details. We know where they are and how they are going on. So these acids are the acids which are dissolved in the body fluids. Now, maintenance of an acceptable pH will range depending upon the three basic mechanisms. That means how this pH in the extracellular fluid is being maintained. It has three main mechanisms. One is the chemical buffer. It acts very rapidly within a fraction of a second, and it acts as a first line of defense for the change in the pH. The second regulation of the acid-base balance is by the respiratory regulation. That means the respiratory system will act to regulate the pH. Now, this takes a bit longer time from seconds to minutes to occur. So it is termed as the second line of defense for regulating the acid-base balance. Now, how do they control? They control it by controlling the level of the carbon dioxide in the blood. Jada carbon dioxide hoga, jada bicarbonate hoga. Right, so that is how the control is there. More the carbon dioxide is getting excreted out, so definitely it will affect the acid base balance within the blood. The third regulatory mechanism is the renal regulatory, where we are more interested right now, because chemical regulatory has been taught to you in biochemistry to a very great extent. I need not go into detail. Respiratory will be taught to you soon once the respiratory system will be talked about. I'll be focusing mainly on the renal regulation, but I cannot go alone. So I need to take other two regulatory mechanisms simultaneously, but I will just give you an overview about those two. We'll be mainly focusing on the renal regulation. This regulation acts a bit slowly. It takes minutes to hours to start its regulatory mechanism for maintaining the acid-base balance. So that's why it is termed as the third line of regulatory mechanism. Now, how does it control? It can excrete out acid. It can prevent the by releasing of more of H plus ion. So it will decrease the pH in the blood. Or vice versa, it can do. It can prevent the excretion of H plus ion, thus making the alkaline blood going towards the normal side. That's the first way it regulates. The second way how it controls is by the bicarbonate ion. You remember that bicarbonate is getting excreted out, secreted out at certain portion, and it is getting reabsorbed. You remember that we had talked about it when we're talking about the tubular functions. So the control of secretion or reabsorption of the bicarbonate ion by the tubular system will actually regulate the pH within the blood. And this regulatory mechanism is very, very potent. That means it starts a bit later, but it remains for a very longer duration of time. Is this much clear? क्या यहाँ तक क्लियर है कि एसिड बेस बैलेंस ओवरऑल कैसे मेंटेन होता है? पहली बात हमने पीएच की बात की, फिर हमने एसिड बेस बैलेंस की बात की. ओके, नाउ अनदर क्वेश्चन व्हाट आई वांट टू आस्क, आई वांट टू सेव माय टाइम, जस्ट वांट टू बी श्योर, डू यू नो अबाउट द बफरिंग सिस्टम इन द बॉडी? ये आपने स्कूल में भी पढ़ा होगा, हेंडरसन हैसलबैच इक्वेशन, दैट पीएच इज इक्वल टू पीके प्लस लॉग बाय टू द बेस 10 सॉल्ट बाय एसिड.